Let's welcome the class of 2012. You may now be seated. I want to welcome you to the 2012 Cap'n Ceremony at Birmingham Southern College. I also want to welcome BSC President General Charles Krulak, First Lady Zandi Krulak, and Provost Dr. Mark Shantz as guests of the Alumni Association, which is sponsoring this afternoon's event. I've been asked to remind all soon-to-be graduates and their parents that commencement is tomorrow at 9 a.m. on the intramural fields. Lineup is no later than 8:15 a.m. at the Methodist Headquarters Conference Center. The Cap'n Ceremony at Birmingham Southern marks the students' transition from student to graduate and from student to alumnus and alumna of Birmingham Southern College. The mortarboard, a vestige of the medieval scholar's costume, is an important symbol in academic life. The term mortarboard for these hats first appeared in the mid-19th century and comes from the resemblance of the hat to the small square board or metal plate on which a bricklayer carries mortar. In the Cap'n Ceremony, each candidate for the degree receives his or her cap as both a mark of significant academic achievement and of a lifelong commitment to the love of learning. Capping is a ceremony of celebration for graduates and for their families and friends. Now I would like to introduce Ms. Megan Snyder, class of 2012, who will lead us in our invocation.
Will you please bow your heads? O holy God, we come together as a community to celebrate the foundations of our very selves. As we make our transition from Birmingham Southern, we remember and celebrate those parents, grandparents, siblings, neighbors, teachers, and friends who carried us here. We cherish the cornerstones of our own life, and we pray that we recall the cornerstones of our college. Add to your faith knowledge. Add to your knowledge wisdom. Add to your knowledge strength. Add to your knowledge inquiry. Add to your knowledge community. Add to godliness kindness, with charity toward all. Amen. Now I'd like to introduce L.J. Campbell, class of 2012 and chair of the Senior Gift Committee, who will recognize the seniors' contributions in the Senior Gift Campaign.
Our class has much to be proud of moving forward as Birmingham Southern alumni. However, one thing that should not be overlooked is the unwavering commitment that this class has shown in our time here. I had the pleasure of serving as the chair of the 2012 Senior Gift Campaign, and I am honored to announce another testament to the commitment of this class. This year, 52% of our class contributed over $12,000 to our school's annual fund. With an increase of over 33%, our class set a new record by raising more money than any other senior class in our institution's history. I want to thank everyone who made their first commitment to BSC this year, and especially those of you who so selflessly committed your time and money to our campaign as our Senior Gift Committee, making this campaign the most successful yet. So this time, will our Senior Gift Committee members please stand so that we can show you our appreciation. Now I would like to introduce Camille Canada, class of 2012 and former SGA president, who will introduce our keynote speaker.
Thank you, LJ. Each year, the seniors at the college are asked to name their favorite professors, and one of those professors is selected to speak at the capping ceremony. This year, seniors recognize Dr. Luann Jacobs. She is an associate professor of education at Birmingham Southern College. Before coming to BSC in 2008, she taught at Alabama A&M University, where she also directed the Professional Development Center. She taught for over 2 decades in public schools at grade levels ranging from high school to kindergarten. Her fields of interest are children's and adolescent literature, critical literacy and critical theory, and instructional methods for literacy instructions. She has published numerous book reviews, encyclopedia entries, book chapters, and essays dealing with her interests. She enjoys working and traveling with a wide variety of students here at BSC and is active on many on-campus events. When she's not spending time in the classroom, she enjoys gardening, cooking, and reading everything she can get her hands on. While she is best known on campus for her wardrobe, funky hair, and snazzy heels, she admits to spending most of her free time barefoot in the dirt and is secretly addicted to Paul Feinbaum and Jock's Radio. Please help me in welcoming this year's keynote speaker, Dr. Luann Jacobs, to the stage.
I sort of feel like baby that's just been put in the corner. You all look so pretty. So, the reason I called this meeting of the graduating class of 2012 is to remind you, and you know who you are, to please return all of the many, many books that you have borrowed from me over the past 4 years before you pack to go home. Thank you. Oh, you wanted me to give a speech too. I almost forgot that part. This graduation marks the end of my 4th year at Birmingham Southern. You may not remember, but we came here together as freshmen. When I look at your faces across the banner of BSE's People Stalker page, I am reminded of that freshman commencement 4 years ago in this very room. You looked so much younger. I was certainly as nervous about the next 4 years as you were. I remember your wide-eyed faces as you progressed through your new faculty, each of us adorned in our academic regalia. How overwhelming that must have been. And I don't know who you were, but I remember one of you whispering, "Look, she's got a tattoo around her ankle. This is gonna be good." And I don't know who you were, but thank you. You kept me from throwing up from my own anxiety. And now I look across this gathering at you wearing academic regalia and see not those anxious first-year students, but men and women who have come to be my friends. Friends who belted out Seasons of Love with me on a road trip to Atlanta 3 years ago, you know who you are, and said, "Wouldn't it be cool if the theater department did Rent while we were here?" Nah, that will never happen. Surprise. Friends who stood elbow deep in sudsy dishes after Hanukkah and Passover feasts, even though we were too stuffed full of food and more than a little Passover wine to move. It's tradition. Friends who traveled half a world away with me to spend January teaching in a rural school in Ghana. Friends who've shared my love for Firefly, classic comics, graphic novels, my love of fabulous shoes, SEC football, and a growing appreciation for Ghanaian Akpeteshi. Again, you know who you are. Friends who have seen me through at least 6 evolutions of hair color in the last 4 years. Friends who have shared my passion for the latest from new and favorite children's and young adult authors. P.S., there's that book reminder again, lest you've already forgotten. So what can I say to this graduating class as you begin your commencement weekend? Well, it's customary for a capping speaker to address you in a lighthearted way from a standpoint of his or her academic discipline. So as a member of the education faculty, I could effectively talk to you about the history of education in the Western world and its impact on you as graduates, but I'm not Mark Lester. Or I could talk to you about the politics of American education in the 21st century, but I'm not Natalie Davis. I could even talk to you effectively about the economics of public education, but I'm not Jason Dunnick. But if you thought, any of you, that I was going to miss this last opportunity to read to you. Well, you selected the wrong person. So close your eyes. Think back. Imagine yourself on a rug in your first grade classroom, or at least the first grade classroom you would have had if I had been your teacher. Now lean in, children. Crawl up in my lap. I will expect you to join in. You'll know when it's your turn. Are you ready? It goes like this. When a Monster is Born, by Sean Taylor, illustrated by Nick Sherratt. Oh, look, you get to see the pictures. When a Monster is Born. When a monster is born, there are two possibilities. Either it's a far away in the forest monster, or it's an under your bed monster. If it's a far away in the forest monster, that's that. Are you getting your cues? But if it's an under your bed monster, there are either it eats you, or you make friends and take it to school. If it eats you, oh, you're so good. But if you take it to school, there are either it sits quietly, does its homework, and becomes the first monster to play for the school basketball team, or it eats the general. Oh, I'm sorry, the principal. If it sits quietly, but if it eats the principal, there are two possibilities. Either it growls, yum, and dances a boogie-woogie, or it growls, sorry, and walks off through the wall. If it dances boogie-woogie, that's that. But if it walks off through the wall, there are two possibilities. Either it sits in the park and scratches its head, or it takes a deep breath and sets off for the faraway forest. If it sits in the park, but if it sets off for the faraway forest, there are either it finds an expensive hotel on the way and decides to sleep in it, or it goes around the back of the hotel, finds a broken umbrella, and decides to sleep under that. If it sleeps in the expensive hotel, but if it sleeps under the umbrella, there are two possibilities. Either a kitchen girl comes out and tips a saucepan of porridge over the monster's head, or the kitchen girl notices the monster and stops in her tracks. If the kitchen girl tips porridge over the monster's head, but if the kitchen girl stops in her tracks, there are either the kitchen girl gives the fright of her life and the monster says, roar, and she runs off shouting, help, 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 or the monster gives her a rose and they fall in love. If the girl runs off shouting, help, 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 there are. Oh, I'm sorry, I messed up. That's that. Okay, my students, I don't ever mess up, right? But if they fall in love, there are. Either she kisses the monster and turns into a handsome young man, or it kisses her and she turns into a monster. Well, if the monster turns into a handsome young man, but if the girl turns into a monster, there are two possibilities. Either the monster says, you look horrible, or the monster says, look, I'm a monster, you're a monster, let's get married. If the monster says, that's that. But if the monster says, let's get married, there are two possibilities. Either the two of them live happily ever after and have a baby monster, or they eat each other. Well, if they eat each other, but if they have a baby monster, there are two possibilities. Either it's a faraway in the forest monster, or it's an under your bed monster. The General is fond of reminding you that a liberal arts education provides you the gift of an agile mind and infinite possibilities. And far be it from me to contradict the General, although frankly, we're about the same size. And unless he pulled some ninja marine moves, especially in these shoes, I think I could take him. The expansive and liberal arts education you have gained, the friendships you have developed, the rich and varied experiences you have shared during your time at Birmingham Southern have prepared you not for infinite possibilities, but for a daily assortment of only two possibilities, the expedient or the extraordinary, the conventional or the inventive, the pragmatic or the visionary, the pedantic or the prophetic. Literature, from books written for the youngest children to classical mythology to our holiest of scriptures, offer glimpses into the power of these daily, often deceptively small choices and possibilities. If you choose that which is expedient, that which is conventional, that which is pragmatic, that which is pedantic, well, that's that. But if you use everything that you have learned, everything you have become while here on the hilltop, to choose the extraordinary, the inventive, the visionary, the prophetic, then once again, there are two possibilities. Endless opportunities for you to transform the world are in your hands. Two possibilities at a time. Choose well. Choose boldly. Choose bravely. Choose audaciously. Choose with the confidence and the competence that you have gained during your 4 years here at Birmingham Southern. And while you're at it, don't forget to be a little bit of a monster. They always have the best adventures. In the words of a recently departed father of monsters, let the wild rumpus begin. Congratulations, graduate. Here are to your possibilities, two at a time. Choose well and forward ever.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Luann, for giving us a little story time this afternoon. I'm Pat Anderson Flowers. I'm the interim vice president for institutional advancement, probably the longest title on the campus. And it is my privilege to welcome you today to the capping ceremony. The Office of Institutional Advancement is home to our alumni affairs team and our fundraising team. The people who greeted you today, stuffed you into the hallway back there, and led you to your seats are all members of the IA staff. It's our job to develop and care for the college's relationships with alumni, donors, and our community. For 4 years, you've been in the care of student affairs and academic affairs. Now it is up to institutional advancement to assist you in building a lifelong relationship with your college. As the hosts of the capping ceremony, we have the honor of welcoming you through the exciting transition from student to alum. We will keep you informed about your alma mater, and we will help you to connect with alumni in your new communities. You just have to let us know where you are when you get there. Hosting the capping ceremony also means that we have the honor and challenge of calling your names as you come forward to be capped. We'll do our best to get every name right, but if we miss it, just let us know. And Terry and I have been instructed to pronounce the names exactly the way you wrote them on the cards.
Terry, would you please join me as we welcome the class of 2012? Terry Smiley, class of 1994. Ushers, will you please now present the first row of candidates to be capped? As they come forward, I'll tell you a little bit about the capping process. Graduates, you'll come to the stage with your cappers, row by row, as directed by the advancement staff. Friends and family, we ask that you hold your enthusiastic applause until after each member of the row is capped. As you take the stage, we're going to help you out by giving you some good directions about how to actually do the capping. Who is our guinea pig? Megan, you're the guinea pig. Okay. So Megan's going to demonstrate for you as I talk you through the process. All right, let's just go ahead and watch Megan as the others get into place. And you've got yellow X's up here that will show you where to stand. The candidate will bend her knees so that the capper can see the top of her head. The capper then places the cap on the graduate's head by first securing the front in place on the forehead and then on the back of the head. The forehead should be partly visible. Graduates, your tassels should remain on the right side until your degree is conferred at commencement tomorrow. At that time, you'll move it to the left. After everyone in the row has been capped and your group has basked in the thunderous applause, you will exit the stage where you entered in reverse order. So the caboose becomes the engine. All right, so now we begin. McGinty Chilcutt is being capped by Jack Chilcutt, his father. Anna Virginia Good, Anna Virginia Good is being capped by Jackie Good. Jackie is her mother. Clara Luthus is being capped by Mandy Thomas. Camille Canada is being capped by Joy Canada, her mother. Larry Campbell is being capped by his mom, Linda Campbell. Megan Stacy Snyder has already been capped by her mother, Teresa Snyder.
Miss Jenica Broom will be capped by her father, Billy Broom. Michael Zachary Williams Glazer will be capped by his mother, Dr. Candace Williams Glazer. Joseph White will be capped by his father, Ralph White. Caleb Patrick Story will be capped by his high school business teacher, Mr. Lee Lott. I hope that's a Mr. or Mrs. Lee Lott, excuse me. William Palmer Jackson will be capped by Colonel Kent Jackson, mentor. And Faith Dorn will be capped by her mother, Christina Dorn.
David Hall is being capped by his father, David Hall. Aisha Bonds is being capped by Rhonda Bonds, her mother. Elizabeth Ann Lefter is being capped by her father, Dan Lefter. Brian Benjamin Grissett is being capped by his father, Dr. Brian I. Grissett. Lauren Elizabeth Miles is being capped by her father, D. Miles. Amelia Elizabeth Banks is being capped by her father, Greg Banks. Caitlin Schmidt is being capped by her mother and best friend, Marissa Smith Schmidt.
Very nice.
Melissa Federer is being capped by her father, Al Federer. Taylor Phillips is being capped by her grandmother, Marty Diller. Ashley Loving is being capped by her aunt, Anita Whitman. Courtney Campbell is being capped by her mother, Melanie Coates. Gregory Nesvik is being capped by his grandfather, Dr. Richard Morrison. Laura is being capped by her cousin, Sergeant Matt Johnson, Laura Parker. Virginia Seal is being capped by her father, Ken Seal.
Courtney Hadley is being capped by her mother, Audra Gilley. John Wilson Truelove is being capped by his mother, Debbie Truelove. Jacob Adams is being capped by his mother, Terry Adams. Oh. Landy Drake Wallace is being capped by her father, Gene Wallace. Jaisha Vaughn is being capped by her stepdad, Keith Morton. William Cade Hovatter, is that right? Is being capped by his personal physician, Dr. Raymond Lyrene. Nicole Michelle Smith is being capped by her mom, Misty Morris.
Congratulations.
Matilda Easterbrook is being kept by her father, Mr. Norman Easterbrook. Claire Elizabeth Burns is being kept by her maternal grandmother, Sue Littlepage. William Tulloch is being kept by his cousin, Dr. Murray Yarbrough. Rauru son, Richardson, is being kept, thank you for the laugh there, but being kept by his mother, Ms. Cheryl Richardson. Parmita Kareem is being kept by her mother, Rashandra Kareem. Colin Curry is being kept by her father, Mr. Dustin Curry.
Well, this group should be interesting. Kimberly Zakow is being kept by her grandfather, Robert Zakow. Ryan Croft is being kept by his mom, Linda Croft. Jack Newton Like the Fig, Dunn the Third, is being kept by his father, Jack Newton Dunn Jr. Laura Moran is being kept by her grandfather, Alfredo Gutierrez. Artem Zhukov is being kept by his mother, Irina Freeman. Carly Manir Kitabshi is being kept by her father, Dr. Abbas Kitabshi.
Okay, Pat, I think my list is just about as tough as your last one. So. Muhammad Jazir is being kept by his mother, Bada Jazir. Laith Omar Bazid is being kept by his father, Sam Bazid. Rachel Tucker is being kept by her mother, Ms. Donna Wade. Jennifer Commander is being kept by her father, Mr. John Commander. Stephen Carter is being kept by his girlfriend, Stephanie Mahalchik. Georgia Cook is being kept by her twin sister, Madeline Cook. And William Palmer is being kept by his brother, Henry Palmer, class of 2009.
Richard Garner Shivers is being capped by his father, Richard Shivers. Claire Johnston is being capped by her mom, Lola Johnston. Drew Little is being capped by his dad, Brad Little. Tyler Evans is being capped by his mother, Melissa Evans. Hay Lee Johnson is being capped by her mother, April Johnson. Dante Carney is being capped by his mother, Deb Carney. Faris Hussein Rujab Pasha is being capped by his professor, mentor, guide, and inspiration, Dr. Richard Proctor.
Thomas G. Webster is being capped by his father, Fred Webster, class of 1977. Laura Stein is being capped by her mother, Sarah Smith. Lee Hall Travis is being capped by his mother, Christy Travis. Ashton Spurgeon is being capped by his nephew, Houston Hart. That's awesome. Judy Cochran is being capped by her grandfather, Mr. Gene Vesna. Samantha Paige Davison is being capped by her father, Mr. Michael Davidson. Julian Leonard Richardson is being capped by his mother, Jacqueline Valentine Richardson.
Sarah Rose, like the flower, Parkinson is being capped by her brother, Anthony Michael Parkinson. Eric Nordgren is being capped by his mother, Becky Nordgren. Avery Tumlin is being capped by her mother, Cindy Tumlin. Patrick David Rowan is being capped by his father, David Pelham Rowan. Jacob McPherson is being capped by his father, Greg McPherson.
Craig McPherson.
Ashley Bice is being capped by her brother, Cameron Bice.
Emma Catherine Harper is being capped by her father, Paul Watkins Harper. Julia Allen Guyton is being capped by her grandmother, Miss Marjorie Hoglund. Maxfield Wexler Daylap is being capped by his father, Mr. Kenneth Daylap. A.G. Baldwin III is being capped by his mother, Cynthia Baldwin, class of 1986. Alan Eckler is being capped by his father, Mr. Scott Eckler. Kelly Lansden is being capped by her father, Mr. Robert Lansden.
Brianna McMath is being capped by her father, Byron McMath. William Hadney is being capped by his teacher, John Henson. William Henry Freeman is being capped by his mother, Betty Lynn Freeman. Brandy Cook is being capped by her father, David Cook. Elena Smith is being capped by her mother, Allison Smith. Daniel Bergen is being capped by his father, Steve Bergen. Rob Aiken is being capped by his father, John Aiken.
Kyle Sebastian is being capped by his father, Mr. Ray Sebastian. Matthew Allen Barnes is being capped by his mother, Miss Cynthia Barnes. Matthew Thurston Zeman is being capped by his father, Mr. Greg Zeman. Joshua Stephen Rabbit is being kept by his grandfather, Mr. Charles Rabbit Sr. Thomas Ray is being kept by his brother and BSC class of 2008, Ford Ray. Hardy Reynolds is being kept by his mother, Lynn Reynolds. Lindsay Driscoll is being kept by his mother, Miss Patricia Driscoll. Congratulations.
Patrick Welsh is being kept by his father, Robert Welsh. Catherine Candler Shannon is being kept by her friend, Sarah Elsie Moore. Hope Elizabeth Harris is being kept by her mother, Debbie Legler. Alessandra Norman is being kept by her father, Julio Norman. Nathan DeRosa is being kept by his mother, Natalie DeRosa. Cynthia Andrews is being kept by her mother, Patricia Andrews.
Winston Croat is being kept by his father, Mr. Charles Croat. Courtney Alexander is being kept by her mother, Jan Alexander. Hannah Howell is being kept by her mother, Ms. Joan Howell. Corbin Ryan Suggs is being kept by his mother, Miss Mary Suggs. Nathaniel Yonce is being kept by his mother, Miss Mary Lee Rice. Robert Mills is being kept by his mother, Miss Elizabeth Mills. John Russell Norris is being kept by Charlie Wigley, distinguished alumna and friend. Okay.
Ernest Floyd Jr. is being kept by his sister, Jennifer Pinkard. Brittany Green is being kept by her high school art teacher, BSC alum, and mentor, Frida Hall. Janae Robertson is being kept by her on-campus mom, Cheryl Waters. Caitlin Glover is being capped by her father, Dr. Gregory Glover, BSc alum of 77. Michael Emfinger is being capped by his mother, Brenda Emfinger. Angela Isom is being capped by her grandmother, Wilma Isom.
I think this is the one that kind of pulls on my heartstrings there with the little ones, but Caitlin Adams is being capped by her niece, Kaylee. John Michael Balligan is being capped by his father, Mr. Michael Balligan. Raina Foster is being capped by her father, Mr. Muhammad Festa. Haley Strassner is being capped by her mother, Debbie Strassner. Kristen Matthews is being capped by a lifelong friend, Aslan Davis. Madeline Walker is being capped by her mother, Mrs. Melanie Walker Malone. And that was Ms. Strassner, Haley Strassner. Hopefully I got it right that time, so excuse me.
Nina Aurora is being capped by her father, Chander Aurora. Joseph Rishlock is being capped by his mother, Claire Rishlock. Jamie Hodge is being capped by her father, Harmon Hodge. Alicia Costa Plotke is being capped by her grandfather, David Plotke. Emmeline Grace Hollis is being capped by her older brother, Patrick Hollis. Lauren Metzger is being capped by her dad, Ken Metzner. Jay Elmore is being capped by his father, Joey Elmore.
Emily Frederickson is being capped by her mother, Patricia Frederickson. Philip Hedgepeth is being capped by his father, Jerry Hedgepeth. Robert Grant Scoble is being kept by his mother, Ms. Jennifer Scoble. Sarah King is being kept by her mother, Linda King. Brittany Soto is being kept by her mother, Andrea Friedman. Dustin Massey is being kept by his mother, Kathy Massey. Amanda Hallbrooks is being kept by her father, Mr. James Hallbrooks.
Congratulations.
Caitlin McCary is being kept by her father, Bob McCary. Justin Bailey is being kept by his mother, Natalie Bailey. Catherine Etka is being kept by her father, Steve Etka. Grant Sly is being kept by his father, Blake Sly. Anna Bianchi is being kept by her mentor, Dr. Amy Cottrell. Robert Aubrey Sturdivant is being kept by his father, Jim Sturdivant. Roland Herbert Windham III is being kept by his father, Roland Herbert Windham Jr.
Kayla Marie Grunemeyer is being kept by her father, Mr. John Allen Grunemeyer. Rebecca Brizard is being kept by her father, Mr. Oscar Brizard. Shin Shu is being kept by his father, Wei Shu. Hey Shu. Swaroop Vita is being kept by little sister Sanya Vita. Ashley Ann Alex is being kept by her mother, Arlene Alex. John Andrew Young is being kept by his aunt, Deborah Sparks. Daniel Thomas is being kept by his father, Mr. David Thomas.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Anna Scott is being kept by Issa Delgado. Kate Talley is being capped by her father, Jeff Talley, class of 1987. Michael Popwell is being capped by his mentor and spiritual leader, Laura Sisson. Samuel H. Brought is being capped by his mother, Sarah Brought. Mark Lowry is being capped by his father, Mark Lowry. William Archibald Roberts, Jr. is being capped by his mother, Lisa Roberts.
Anna Davis is being kept by her grandmother, Miss Jean Thrillkill. Samantha Key Waitley is being kept by her mother, Miss Lucy Key. Mary Virginia Bain is being kept by her father, Mr. Arlen Bain. Got it covered, Dad, got it covered. Robin Milkey is being kept by her mother, Miss Debbie Milkey. Sarah Sharman is being kept by her mother, Lisa Sharman. Victoria Naden is being kept by her father, Dean Naden. Leonard Dubuisson is being kept by his father, Mr. Leonard Dubuisson, Jr.
Thank you, sir. All right. Thank you. Congratulations.
Danielle Mayer is being capped by her mother, Marie Mayer. Sarah Watts is being capped by her mother, Wimberly Watts, class of 1987. Tabitha Mays is being capped by her father, Gil Mays. Megan Sandlin is being capped by her mother, Carol Sandlin. David Litton is being capped by his twin, Julie Litton. Eleanor Lentz is being capped by her advisor and teacher, Dr. Timothy Smith. And Allison Boyd is being capped by her father, Dr. Ali C. Boyd III.
Lindsay Lanier Daniel is being capped by her teacher and mentor, Dr. Sandra Sprayberry, Melissa Sewell is being capped by her sister, Heather Sewell. Jessie Main is being capped by her advisor, voice teacher, and friend for 4 years, Dr. David Smith. Catherine Patton is being capped by her older sister, Kimberly Patton. Mary McDaniel is being capped by her father, Mr. Giles McDaniel. Sarah McCoon is being capped by Reverend Jack Hennon, the spiritual guru, is what I got down here. DJ Ward is being capped by his mother, Miss Melissa Ward.
Tyon Rangang,
otherwise
known as TR, is being capped by his advisor and bridge opponent, Dr. Doug Riley. Leslie Ann Dupre is being capped by her father, Mr. Leslie Dupre. Chloe Roselle is being capped by her mother, Cindy Roselle. Abigail Dawn Gillis is being capped by her son, Braylon Jackson Gillis. John Paul Toratorich is being capped by his senior research sponsor, Dr. Peter Van Zandt. Catherine LaCroix is being capped by her professor of biology, Dr. Peter Van Zandt. Kindred Case Motes is being capped by her father, Fred W. Motes Jr. This one. Kindred even put the mail sign on here for me, and I didn't see it.
Hannah Elise Wiry is being capped by her mother, Miss Beth Wiry. Sarah Beckett Pittman is being capped by her brother, Jerry Brunson Pittman. Alexis Gilmore is being capped by her mother, Clara A. Gilmore. Amy Sessions is being capped by her mentor, Dr. Caitlin Greer Rossman. Catherine Elizabeth Screven is being capped by her grandmother, Mama Lee Ledbetter. Is that right, Mama Lee? Okay, all right. I don't want Mama to get upset with me now. Ashley Aline Hudson is being kept by her mother, Miss Sandra Hudson. Monicia Charisse Miller is being kept by her mother, Miss Stephanie Miller.
Yuan Gong is being kept by her mother, Jiao Yu. Ingvi Thor Georgsen is being kept by his father, George Paulson. Linda Amaya is being kept by her father, Felicito Mayo. Caroline Crawford is being kept by her father, Bruce Crawford. Blakely Childress is being kept by her mother, Kim Childress. Galen Andrew Brunson is being kept by his father, Richard Brunson.
Shelby Beatty is being kept by her father, Dr. Bob Beatty. Erica Grace Lasky is being kept by her father, Mr. James David Lasky. Brian Teed is being kept by his mentor and professor, Dr. Bill Myers. Elizabeth Ann McCoy is being kept by her father, Dr. William John McCoy IV. Hillary Grace Beard is being kept by her father, Mr. John Lewis Beard Jr. Michael A. Stonewall is being kept by his mother, Miss Marie Stonewall.
Congratulations. Thank you. Congratulations. Congratulations. Thank you, sir.
Amy Johnson is being kept by her mother, Ann Lacey Johnson. Antonio Slabko Costanan III is being kept by his mother, Consuelo Costanan. Catherine Moore Blackstone is being kept by her dad, Larry Blackstone. Walter Llewellyn is being kept by his brother and class of 2008, Ben Llewellyn. John Michael Chappell is being kept by his father, Class of 1982, Mike Chappell. Thomas Caton Jackson is being capped by his professor, Dr. Daniel Coyle.
Lucas Strickland is being capped by his mother, Ms. Dawn Strickland. Christy Schellenberger is being capped by her mother, Karen Schellenberger. Erica Lee Ogle is being capped by her mother, Amy Lee. Sarah Lindsay Minton is being capped by her father, Mr. Timothy Minton. Chris Clark is being capped by his aunt, Ms. Susan Lagana. Catherine Stewart is being capped by her mother, Leanne Stewart. Virginia Ann Jordan is being capped by Professor Mary Kate Lizotte. Yes.
Brenna McGee is being capped by her brother, Andrew McGee. Aaron Brown is being capped by his uncle, Gordon Webb. Jenny Mallett is being capped by her mother, Susie Mallett. Abby Campbell is being capped by her grandfather, Ken Guthrie. Sarah Spruill is being capped by her mother and class of 1984, Sheila Spruill. And Ann Jackson Peebles is being capped by her father, Tommy Peebles.
Ronald Matthew Parker Jr. is being capped by his father, Mr. Ronald Parker Sr. Caleb Lee is being capped by his brother, Joshua Lee. Haley Elizabeth Martin is being capped by her father, Mr. George Martin. Alex Wilson is being capped by his father, Mr. Alan Wilson. Laura Sullivan Hale is being capped by his father, Mr. John Hale. Patrick Eubank is being capped by his father, Mr. Greg Eubank.
Congratulations.
Can I just say that it's really a good thing that penmanship is not part of the graduation checklist? John Thompson is being capped by his father, Robert Thompson. Haley Steinbuschel is being capped by her grandfather, Conrad Johnson. Ryan Hodup is being capped by his mother, Louise Hodup. Richard Lee Perlman is being capped by his father, Robert Lawrence Perlman. John Morris is being capped by his brother, Joe Morris. And Emily Roebuck is being capped by her mother, Kathy Powell Roebuck.
This is our final group, but definitely not taken away from the group. But is it not a lot of love in this building right now? Give yourselves a hand. Kelsey Shipley, being capped by instructor and mentor Alan Litzy. Or Litzy. Litzy? Nathan Merritt is being capped by professor, mentor, and salad of inspiration, Dr. Alan Litzy. Okay. The best to the last there. Mary Ann Rose MacArthur, being capped by BSC theater professor and mentor, Dr. Alan Litzy. A busy professor. Mitchell Jean Swanson, being capped by his grandmother, Miss Judy Sheffon.
While they're returning to their seats, let's have one final round of applause for our class of 2012. And now Sherry Salmon, 1985 alumna and Associate Vice President for Admission, will present the class of 2012 for membership into the BSC Alumni Association.
Thanks, Pat. You guys did great. I got to see everybody come up here too, so it was a special treat for me. And Luann, I need to say how much I enjoyed your comments, but kung fu military moves aside, my money's on the general. No, I'm here to bring you, as Pat said, congratulations upon your impending graduation, and it will happen tomorrow, and want to present you as candidates to the Birmingham Southern College Alumni Association. I too remember, as we've most said up here, 4 years ago, your faces were lit up with excitement and enthusiasm, but also hesitation and nervousness. Many of you just left the rank of senior in high school and were pushed back to freshman at Birmingham Southern College. Now you're leaving the ranks of being a senior again, only to start climbing the ladder of success. This time, however, you are armed with a Birmingham Southern College education, and that will put you right over the top. The future is unknown, then you will face many challenges, but let me assure you one thing. You are already a step ahead of the others. You have the skills to think critically, to analyze quickly, to resolve conflict with integrity and assurance. At the heart of every decision made at Birmingham Southern is its students. Birmingham Southern College continues to change to meet the needs of the students. Being a student is a wonderful thing, but the next best thing is being an alum. That's one thing you'll have to learn too. If you're a female, you are an alumna. And if there are two females together, you are referred to as alumni. Now, if you're a gentleman, you are an alumnus. And two of you happen to be together, you are alumni. If all else fails, just do what I do and say alums. Whatever category you fit into, you will truly enjoy participating in the Birmingham Southern College Alumni Association. I'm assuming you'll stay active in this association because there's truly no reason not to. Through the association, you will continue to keep in touch with your friends and celebrate those friendships forever. You'll ensure the success of the college by becoming a recruiter, and that's near and dear to my heart. Through this association, you'll also have the opportunity to serve as a mentor for future Birmingham Southern students or go on a service learning trip as a chaperone. Finally, you'll have the opportunity to support your alma mater's future students through your yearly gifts to the annual fund. You know your education was funded by tuition dollars, but what you might not know is that over half was funded by gifts from alumni and friends of this college. As an alum, you'll be given the opportunity to give to the college's annual fund each year. Your gift will support scholarships, student research, service learning programs, and many other programs and opportunities for our students. I'm proud to call each and every one of you a fellow alumni and wish you luck as you go through this weekend's activities. I hope you know my office doors are always open. Candidates, please rise. Terry, it is with great honor that I present the class of 2012 to you, current president of this esteemed BSC family, for lifelong membership into the Birmingham Southern College Alumni Association. Congratulations.
Graduates, I would like to welcome you to the Birmingham Southern College Alumni Association. As president of the Alumni Association, I would like to say welcome to the family. Today you join an elite group, a close family, the men and women who are the alumni of BSC. You now have a network of people that are eager to help you be successful, but you also are part of a group in whose hands the future of this institution rests. Both in terms of our effect on the world and what we accomplish in our lives, and our impact on future students here through the support of this institution with our energy and our resources. The day you came to campus as a first-year student, you were given statistics at the opening ceremony about your class, where you were from, the number of national merit finalists. Now I would like to give you some statistics about the alumni you're joining. Welcome to an international group of alumni numbering more than 14,500. Among us, you can find some 400 artists of all kinds, 3,500 business persons, 2,000 educators, more than 500 government and military employees, 700 homemakers, more than 150 journalists, 1,400 medical professionals, 400 ministers, 450 scientists, and almost 700 lawyers, of whom 300 work in the greater Birmingham area. Today at your cap'n ceremony, we continue with one of our newest traditions. As you leave the Coliseum today, we have a gift for you. And we will for each and every graduating class that comes after you. As you pack and unpack boxes numerous of times in the years ahead, we hope this will remind you that you have more than 14,000 alumni supporting you. The gift this year is a special ornament comprised of bronze ginkgo leaves. We hope it will remind you of those fall days when you walked out of Munger Hall and were met by golden ginkgo leaves. The ginkgo is said to be the oldest seed-bearing plant and has therefore become a symbol of longevity and hope. It is known as a living fossil and is the only remaining species of a genus that flourished with the dinosaurs. Now, I'm talking about the real dinosaurs, not the old alumni like myself. It was the ginkgo among all trees that was found unblemished in Hiroshima in the aftermath of atomic destruction. At BSC, these trees have become symbols of service and loyalty to the college. And I would like to say that again. At BSC, these trees have become symbols of service and loyalty to the college. Finally, a word about legacy. The legacy of Birmingham Southern lives in the generations of his sons and daughters. When you came to the hilltop, you became a part of that living legacy. As you leave, you continue living it. But now you also join the rest of us who are simultaneously proud caretakers of that legacy, the alumni of Birmingham Southern College. As I close, remember that there are thousands of us celebrating with you this weekend, and we welcome you to our family. We are proud of you, and we need your help in caring for this great lady that is BSC. And as our great leader, General Krulak, often says, forward ever. Now I would like to introduce Clara Lutas, class of 2012, who will lead us in singing the alma mater.
Please rise and join us as we sing the Birmingham Southern alma mater, and the words are on the screen and printed on the back of your program. Following singing of the alma mater, please remain standing.
Class of 2012, we salute you and wish you well. The ushers will direct you out of the room by rows, beginning with the last row. Everyone, please join me in applause for these seniors.